same type we have to use for juniors. Juniors for 20 weeks. Chi square is equal to summation. The observed value for junior is 10, whereas expected value for junior is 10.5. 10 minus 10.5 whole square divided by expected value 10.5. So the result will be 0.0238. Now for 10 weeks, chi square is equal sum of juniors for 10 weeks. 10 weeks is 14 for observed value, and 10 weeks 13.2 for expected value. 14 for observed value and 13.2 for expected value whole square divided by expected value 13.2. So the sum total of this frequencies will be 0.0484. Now for the num with the same formula for num, juniors 6 for observed category and juniors 6.3 for expected category. Chi square is equal to sum of 6 for observed value minus 6.3 for expected value whole square divided by 6.3, which is approximately equals to 0.00681. So the subtotal of these figures will be 0.079018. This is the subtotal of junior. So now with the same type for the last category, senior. So senior for 20 weeks, chi square is equal to summation. Senior for 20 weeks 14 for 20 weeks and expected values are 14 minus 14 whole square divided by 14 is equal to 0. So for 10 weeks, chi square is equal to sum of 16 for observed values for 10 weeks and 17.6 for expected values for 10 weeks. 16 minus 17.6 for expected values divided by 17.6 for expected values. So the result will be, so the total of this frequency will be 0.1454. Now for none, chi square is equal to summation for none category in senior is 10, and for expected value in senior category for none is 8.4. 10 is expected value minus 8.4 is observed value whole square divided by 8.4. So the total sum total of this frequency will be 0.3045. 4, 7. So the total of these senior frequencies will be 0.4501. Now we have to add these sum totals. Okay, for fresh 0.0894 plus for soft subtotal 0.08156 plus for junior 0.079018 plus for senior subtotal 0.4501 0.709. The subtotal will be 0.709 for this and this will be the 0.709. this is the calculated value of chi square calculated value is equal to 0.709. so these values are obtained, this chi square value, final grand total 0.709, which is obtained from the subtotal of this junior, senior and fresh and soft. Addition of these values, we obtained the chi square result 0.709, a grand total. So this value is basically obtained. Okay, so now the decision. Decision rule is that if chi-square calculated value is more than chi-square UR tabulated value, then reject H naught and accept HA. So the general rule is that if chi square calculated value is more than chi square critical or tabulated value, then reject H naught and accept alternative hypothesis. If chi square value is less than tabulated value, then accept H naught and reject HA. So this is a general rule. Now the decision is that the calculated value of chi square is equal to So here, conclusions that there is not sufficient evidence that meal plan and class standing are related or associated at alpha 0.05 or 5% significance level. So this is the conclusion. This is not sufficient evidence that meal plan and class standing are related, associated at 5% significance level. So we tried to test the two hypotheses. One is an alternative hypothesis, one is a null hypothesis. So null hypothesis says that there is no any relationship between these two plans, meal plan and class standing. These are the two categorical variables. Whereas alternative hypothesis says that no, there is some kind of relationship or association between them. So we try to test these two hypotheses and we find out that the H naught is accepted. Why? Because value which are obtained, which are calculated in independence test is 0.709, which is less than 12.592, which is tabulated value. So in this situation, we can not reject the null hypothesis and we can reject the alternative hypothesis. Alternative says that there is some kind of relationship, but this we find that there is no any kind of relationship between meal plan and class standing. So the alternative hypothesis is rejected and null hypothesis is accepted. So there is not sufficient evidence that meal plan and class standing are related or associated. So I hope you can understand the lecture regarding the test of independence, regarding the cross tabulation, how cross tabulation will be incurred in the test of independence. Hope the question of the answer. Thank you very much.